terrified. I've never been so frightened all of my life. I'll never forget that night as long as I live. Oh, you see that boy over there? That's right, that was me. I could feel my heart pounding in my chest. I remember my father quoting from Isaiah, "The people who walk in darkness shall see a great light." Well, let me tell you, that was one great light. I thought we were dreaming. But you know, something's always puzzled me about that night. Why would the God of the universe choose to reveal to a bunch of simple shepherds the birth of our Lord? We were common people, not royalty, not special. I guess God uses simple.
Yeah. this crazy dream last night. An angel spoke to me, said it's all right. Oh, sweet Mary carries God's own son, and you shall call his name Jesus. Don't be afraid, take Mary to be your bride. And don't be afraid, take Mary to be your bride. An angel spoke to me last night.
Every time you turn around. anything about tomorrow.
He'd like to cheat a few more people today. Well, don't you feel just a little bit sorry for these poor people? Why, Caesar barks and we all jump.
Sorry? Why should I feel sorry for them? I rather like this Caesar fellow. He sounds like a very honest politician. He's made me a very happy man.
Always thought you were a little greedy there, Jonas.
Why, I'm not greedy. I'm just a humble businessman trying to eke out a humble living for my humble family.
Ha! The only one you care for is your penny-pinching self.
Why, I'm a Paul.
You're a tightwad.
I am a meager merchant, an honest entrepreneur.
You are an old giblet. So, Jonas, what are you going to do now that you're in a school for the night?
Yes, you wouldn't think of doing it with your own bed, would you?
I was thinking of maybe remodeling the place. The rooms are a bit oversized, and we could use the kitchen as another room. I mean, people do like to eat out, you know. Here's an idea. How about an apartment over the stable? For that matter, who needs animals anyway? They're loud and they're noisy and messy.
Always looking for an angel there, huh, Jonas?
I can't help it, friends.
There's never too much, is there, Jonas?
Too much? Too much? Bite your tongue. There's never enough.
How much is enough, Jonas?
Why, just a little bit more, of course. Wait a minute. Take a deep breath. Do you smell that?
No, what is it?
Why, it's money! It's a glorious night in Bethlehem. There's commerce in the air. My inn is filled with pain, yes. Each room is booked for fare. I feel just like a child again, with candy in my hand. But shekels are much sweeter to any businessman. And if I had one wish to wish, I know it might sound funny. I'd wish for one more room to rent, for just a little more money. Yeah. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Who needs friends and family when it's money? So Rome can count their noses. They squeeze us, tax us, boy they would have never seen the Moses. But I never had a better friend than Caesar, don't you see? They must all have room and board, so I'm the man they need. But what I'd give for one more bed, I would not hesitate. I'd sell it twice. Anyone who's me.
in the Lord of Lords, and there was no place for him to be born except where animals take their meals. The world was being visited by the King of all creation, and this was how it went.
Thank you. really quite amazing to think that the God who created the heavens and the earth, He who formed the billions of stars and calls them all by name, would have in His being love for you and for me. But the Bible says He did love us, and He does love us. And because of His great love, He gave His only begotten Son. And whosoever should believe on Him, the Bible says, they will not perish, but they shall have everlasting life. Centuries before Jesus came into this world, born of a virgin, the prophet Isaiah said, the Lord will give a sign unto you. You will find a child born of a virgin, wrapped in swaddling clothes. The prophet Isaiah said, unto us a child is given, unto us a son is born. And He shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And the Bible tells us that in due time, just at the right time, God sent His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, that He might redeem those also born under the law. That's you and me. That we might receive full rights as His sons. The Bible tells us Jesus was born, and this is why we celebrate Christmas, because of the coming of Messiah. And then the scripture tells us He lived a tremendous, fantastic, sinless life, healing the brokenhearted, healing those with physical ailments, living a life of love, ever bearing in mind the cross that loomed before Him. Well, the scripture tells us that He was the Lamb of God slain before the foundation of the very world. That He came so that He Himself might become that final sacrifice for the sins of the world. And you and I, we cannot live a life that merits God's love, but Jesus did. Jesus Himself said, even as Moses lifted up a serpent in the wilderness, even as people looked to that serpent on that pole and they were healed of their diseases and they were healed of that which would take them to death, Jesus said, even so the Son of Man must be lifted up. And Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men, all women, all boys, all girls unto myself. And the promise is that He went to that cross, and the scripture tells us that He died on that cross, bearing our sin in His body on the tree, that we might die unto sin, but that we might live unto righteousness. The scripture says, by His stripes we are healed. And the Bible says, the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. The scripture teaches us that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Judea, and that He died on the cross, Golgotha. But the glorious news is that He rose from the dead. And on that third morning, the Bible says there was a great earthquake, that the angel appeared, and that Jesus Himself rose from the dead, victorious over death and hell and the grave. And His offer is that you too might have that victory. If you believe in Him, if you receive it. Scripture says, God has done His part. He sent His only begotten Son to die on the cross for your sin and for mine. And now, the scripture says that we have to do our part. To as many as received Him, He gave the right to become children of God. It's a very simple thing, and we're going to offer you morning to find Him. It begins by confessing your sin and by asking the Lord Jesus to forgive you because of your sin. It continues by asking the Lord Jesus to come into your life to be your Savior and your Lord. If you'd like to do that this morning, and know the God of all creation, the God of supreme love, you can do that right now. I'm going to ask if you would, every person here, now if you would just bow your heads and close your eyes.